Hey, it's Dan, and welcome to my series on leading remote teams, where I discuss 10 specific aspects of how you as a leader may better manage and lead remote teams. In this episode, Remote Leadership 101, really the basics about how to lead remote teams. Now, here's the fast fact. If people haven't worked from home before, they're going to be a bit freaked out for many different reasons. First of all, they don't really know what they're doing. How do they access their, you know, friends? What are they absolutely up to? It's different. They're used to going into work. They're used to commuting. They're used to ultimately having an idea of how their day operates. And now they're working from home and they may not have ever done this before or occasionally. So they might be a wee bit freaked out. So some of my best, if you will, remote leadership 101 tips are real simple. First of all, there's got to be two-way trust. You know, just because you may not have led people before in terms of being remote workers doesn't mean that you need to immediately start distrusting them. They're still the same people that were going to work yesterday. Now they're just doing it for home. So what they need to see from you is trust. Trust them unequivocally. And in return, if you do that, I admit to you that they will trust you more because they may not be seeing you as much, but given that you're giving them that trust from a distance, they will look up to you and behoove them to give you that trust. Number two, as much as it seems weird, what I'd like you to think about is adding more frequent and informal, shorter type of check-ins with the team. Now that could be huddles, 10-minute huddles that start each day or every other day. That could be little uses of technology, like a text or an email, or maybe a DM or an IM that just says, hey, how you doing? What's up? Can I help you? Those are really powerful words. Can I help you? And if you do that frequently, as opposed to sort of like once a week, then what happens is the trust builds and that individual employee knows that you're there for them. Number three, more than ever, we need to set clear expectations. And that is, what are the employees responsible for now that you won't be able to see them every kind of second in the hallway, at the office, at their desk, what have you? So if you're crystal clear with what you expect of them in terms of deliverables, in terms of how it is that they're supposed to be operating, it's gonna go a long way indeed, again, back to that trust statement there. Humor, can you have a little fun? Okay, COVID-19 and the pandemic is no fun right now, but ultimately we need to have a little more fun in our lives. Otherwise, people are going to be anxious and nervous and stressed and going to be miserable. So what can you do to have a little more fun, albeit from a remote perspective? Could you maybe share crazy memes out there? You know, appropriate, politically sensitive ones, obviously. Could you maybe tell some jokes? Could you get people to sort of share some of their humor that they're kind of getting into? And when you're exchanging communications with your team, try to infuse a little bit of humor there as well. It's gonna go a long, long way for you. Share what you're up to. So no one really wants to know that the leader is all clandestine and kind of secretly moving around their home or wherever it is that they're working from without really knowing what they're up to. Be open. Say what you're doing. Say you went for a walk. Say you went to the beach. That's okay, right? We're not completely all quarantined into our homes. So can you just let people know what you're up to? Be human. Say, you know, I'm going to take the afternoon off. Or say in an email or a conference call or what have you, this is what I'm up to right now. This is what I'm up to this week. The more that you're transparent and open, it relieves stress with the teammates that are out there working on their own potentially for the first time at home. What about an online community? You know, not everything can be synchronous. You can't bump into each other in the hallways anymore. You can't have the water cooler chats, if you will. So what can you do to recreate some of those bumps in the elevators, up the stairwell, you know, at the front desk, wherever it is your office is set up? Can you recreate those? So could you ultimately use tech as a friend, right? In one of these sessions, I talk a little more in depth about technology. But what type of collaboration platforms or community platforms could you use in order to allow people to collaborate, to mingle, to have those collisions? And remember, in this day and age, yes, face-to-face is so important. But in this case, with the COVID-19 outbreak and the pandemic, you've got to make technology your friend. So there's no hiding and escaping from it. It's for you. So embrace it. And then lastly, don't freak out. Things are going to go sideways. Things are going to be broken. Someone's not going to be understanding how they get online, or someone may not be able to realize that it's important that they get this particular deliverable done because they've been so used to you being over their desk or being able to walk up to them and say, hey, how's it going? All of it's different now. Your team is dispersed. You've been used to being face-to-face or maybe a couple times a week some people might go away. Now it's all the time. So you can't freak out as a leader when things go sideways. They will. Trust me. So what you need to employ, as we'll talk about later, is empathy, patience, kindness, consideration. If you don't, they're going to freak out, the employees. And what happens then? Disengagement, not going to get their deliverables done somewhat obviously, and panic. And we don't want any of that. So from a remote leadership 101 basics perspective, think of it this way. Imagine you're virtually building a house together. You need everyone. And yes, you are the architect, you're the tradesperson, you're the general contractor, you're that as the leader, but you need all of these people to help you build that house or that barn. If you're not poetically allowing yourself to be a different type of leader, that is someone who's distant from space perspective, but technologically and virtually present, this virtual house is never going to get built. So I hope you enjoyed some of these 101 tips, more in the series called Leading Remote Teams with me, Dan Pontefract.